बिस्मिल्लाहिर्रहमानिर्रहीम, अस्सलाम वालेकुम डियर स्टूडेंट्स ऑफ क्लास नाइन्थ। टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू टीच यू चैप्टर नंबर 3 एटॉमिक स्ट्रक्चर। लास्ट क्लास सो वी हैव डन एक्चुअली 10 पार्ट्स ऑफ दिस क्लासेस, दिस चैप्टर इन 3 क्लासेस। नाउ दिस इज़ द लास्ट क्लास। नाउ व्हाट टॉपिक्स आर रिमेनिंग? रेडियो एक्टिव रेज, रदरफोर्ड एटॉमिक मॉडल, weaknesses of Rutherford atomic model, Niels Bohr's model. And before doing Niels Bohr's model, you must learn what is spectrum. Okay, so let's start. Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Radioactive rays, you already know that there are 3 types of radioactive rays. You have done in nuclear chemistry. When a nucleus goes under decay, so it will release 3 kinds of rays. These rays are basically invisible, but their names are alpha, beta and gamma rays. Alpha rays are actually helium nucleus, because nucleus is positively charged. Helium nucleus contains 2 protons. It means alpha rays contains 2 protons. They are equal to helium nucleus. Beta rays, which is electron basically, it means it has negative charge. And gamma rays are do not have any charge, and they are represented as photon, a kind of energy. Okay, so basically there are 3 kinds of rays: alpha rays, beta rays and gamma rays. Now, who has discovered these rays? Ernest Rutherford determined the nature of radioactive rays and showed separation of 3 types of rays. Now you can open your book, page number 47. You can see this diagram in your book. What he did, what experiments he did. A sample of radioactive substance was placed in a lead block. You can see here, this is a lead block and this is a radioactive substance kept here. Between the two oppositely charged plates in an electric field. You can see here, this is positively charged and this is negatively charged. These are 2 metal plates that are oppositely charged plates producing an electric field. So this radioactive substance, the radiations were resolved into 3 components. One component was deflected towards the negative plate. Okay, this radioactive substance is emitting 3 kinds of rays, but we cannot see these plates. A photographic plate made them visible. So now you can see that one component was deflected towards the negative plate. Okay, one component in green line you can see deflected towards the negative plate. These are named as alpha rays. It means that they carry positive charge, because when they are positive, they will move towards negative. Okay, unlike charges attract each other, that's why. And then second, you can see the second component deflected towards the positive plate, this one. These are known as beta rays, that I have told you they are basically electrons and they have negative charge. It means beta rays have negative charge, and these were named. The third type carried no charge and no mass and were deflected in the electric and not deflected in the electric field. These were named gamma rays. You can see this one. Okay, so this is the diagram showing the experiments done by Ernest Rutherford for the separation of alpha, beta and gamma rays that are called radioactive rays. Okay, now next topic is Rutherford atomic model. You can see this is the apparatus used by Rutherford. This is a foil, very thin foil, which is made up of gold metal, and here is a screen. Here is a slit between the screen. This is a box in which having a particle, in which having a material which is emitting alpha particles. What are alpha particles? I have told you that are positively charged. Basically, they are equal to helium nucleus. Helium nucleus contain 2 protons. It means they are having 2 protons, equal to 2 protons. Okay, they are going to gold metal foil. So what happened? So when you are going to write this atomic model,